I think it's always good to meet new people. I mean, I'm new to the kind of this side of the sports industry, but working with Sky F1 and the TV side of things. So I'm going to see a little bit more about, you know, all the efforts that other people put in to develop their sport.
New F1 season just getting underway, really, in some respects. What do you think so far? What can we look forward to over the rest of the season?
I think you can look forward to pretty close, intense competition between a number of teams, at least four or five teams, and four or five drivers, possibly more drivers than that as well. So I think Formula One is looking strong.
How do you think the sport's evolved over the past, say, 10 years?
Well, I think it's evolved. I think it went through a crisis. I think it went through a period where it realised that just what people watching cars going round wasn't stimulating enough, and they needed to do something to make it more difficult for people to dominate, and they've done that. Now it's very hard for one team to get ahead, and it means that the entertainment value has gone up, and we're really starting to see some great racing.
I think periods of Formula One history have always been kind of dominated by particular rivalries that I think have characterised the sport. Are there any at the moment that you're especially looking forward to getting played out over the course of this season?
Well, they seem to be put out, the fires to be put out a little more quickly. We had a bit of an issue with Webber and Sebastian Vettel a while back. That's maybe still a bit simmering, but pretty much they're all good. I mean, Jenson Button and Sergio Perez, we fully expected them to get out of the car last race and be at each other's throats, but they damped it all down, and I think they're much more professional these days. They don't let things get out of hand.
Of course, I guess the big word is teamsmanship. What's your opinion on that? I mean, particularly the issue of drivers from one team being kind of instructed to give preference to other people for the sake of points.
Well, it's a complicated aspect of the sport, Formula One. It is a team, but it's not a team as far as the driver is concerned. The driver is either on the upside of the team or he's the flip side. So drivers have to struggle to stay on top in their team, and the teams struggle to try and provide equal opportunity for each driver. But when you get down to a championship, you start to get to the position where it's better for teams to apply some sort of strategy amongst their own drivers against the other teams they're competing with.
I mean, the final question, what do you think it is that distinguishes F1 from all other motorsports?
Well, it's got a machine in it. I mean, most sports have got a stick or maybe a ball, or you don't have anything, like you're just running. But so the machinery, the technical side of it, and the business side of it, I think, make it more complex, more fascinating for some people. But deep down, the really important bit is that guys drive these cars absolutely at their limit, and they race absolutely on the limit. And they're young, very talented, very competitive guys, and that's what people like to see.